Welcome back to the Only Ackies channel. It's finished here. Hamilton 1, Edinburgh City 0. And a game, first game back for fans in, what, 16-month, 18-month? And was it worth the wait? Probably not. A dominant first half saw us go in at halftime 1-0. Callum Smith with the goal. David Moyle just making sure to get that follow-up. Atmosphere was brilliant. That was the best part about the game, was the fans in the ground. Singing, chatting, getting to catch up with folk you haven't spoken to in nearly 2 years is brilliant. And like I said, was the best part of it. A lot of youth on the bench. Few getting cameos. Marley Redfern coming off the bench. See, other than that, it's a strong team. And it's probably the team with... if the remaining players are out injured as they are, that's the team I would probably expect us to go with. The biggest point of the game would be the goal, or the Joe Hilton save, probably in about the 90th minute. The Edinburgh City player was through one-on-one, saved it well with his feet, and it was one of those games where, you know, kind of common Ackies, once we got the goal, we kind of sat back, we didn't threaten up front nearly at all. David Moyle again offering very little. The biggest thing was we came away with a win, and most importantly, the fans were back, which is the most important thing. And I think the players liked that as well. You know, they came over and applauded us at the end. And I think you can tell that it was one of those games where legs were starting to tire. You know, we started getting less creative as the game went off, as the game went on. And I think fans probably pushed them through that kind of last 10 minutes, because Edinburgh City were pretty dominant in the last, I'd say, 20-15 minutes. They didn't offer much either, let's be honest, except for that that shot that ended up with the Joe Hilton save. Ackies fans were getting a little bit kind of tense at the end. As I said, we know Ackies aren't great at holding leads, so when it got to the last kind of 10-15 minutes and Edinburgh City were pushing, folk got a bit worried, and understandably so. But yeah, the game really highlighted the fact that we do still need to bring some players in. We definitely need a striker, as mentioned previously. I do think we need another midfielder, because our options are weak. You know, if a Dolphin does go, you're looking at a midfield of Martin, if he's fit, and Mimnon Hughes, who started today. My kind of biggest problem was when we had the ball in the first half and we were dominant, people like Mimnon stood out and Lewis Smith. But then in the second half, when we dropped back and Edinburgh City were dominating, that midfield, same as last year, was non-existent almost, because Dolphin was doing his best to clean up, but other than that, Hughes and Mimnon were kind of played out the game, and it made us so weak in midfield. So I'd say another midfielder, definitely a striker, and possibly a right back would be my signings. I'd say there are a lot of players out injured, and I don't want to sound too much about Brian Rice when I say, you know, they're like eight new signings, you know, but people like David Templeton, Scott Martin, Scott McMahon, who would be in that team realistically. Scott McMahon, Keenan McDonald, maybe touch and go, but they're the players that would be in that team, and they would make a difference, let's be honest. It does not mean, though, we don't need signings, which we definitely do. As I said, that is probably going to be our team at the start of the league against Wraith, unless we bring MD in or MD comes back from injury. And if that's the team we're going in with, it's a weird one, because you look at it on paper and it's fairly strong. You know, one, Easton, a Dolphin, you know, Mimnon, McDonald, all involved, good players. But as I've said a million times, signings are still needed, and let's cross our fingers the club do it.
So guys, it is the day after Brandon sobered up a wee bit. Let's look back at the game. As I said just before this, I thought first half we were very dominant and looked very good. And in the second half, we reverted a little bit back to old Ackies, where we sat back and tried to defend the league and kind of invited Edinburgh City on. I was wondering what your guys' thoughts were. Brandon, I'll come to you first, mate. What did you make of the game?
First half, we, as you said, completely dominated. Strolled about. Edinburgh City were really poor. Mm-hmm. I think if you're playing a slightly better team there, you're going to have problems. But it was just amazing to be back. That's all I took it. Really wouldn't have mattered to me if we were 10 times worse than that. It was just brilliant to be back. Said to myself I wasn't going to drink, but I drank because of the occasion. And no, it was just amazing to be back. But I really average performance. Hopefully that gives the manager and the board a bit of a kick up the arse to realise that signings they need made. We created chances, but we just couldn't score. So hopefully that does sort of kick them on to get a striker. I know Andy Ryan's injured, but I think, as we mentioned in the podcast during the week, we need somebody else on top of that as well.
And David, what about you? How are you feeling?
Again, same as Brandon. I'm buzzing, but I was even there last night. Definitely a game of two halves. First half, I was genuinely surprised to see the way we were moving the ball and dominating. I think we were doing well with Kieran McDonald down the left-hand side. Second half, you might put that down to the fact that this is the first kind of proper game they've had. I mean, bounce games, obviously, they can change the entire lineup at half time. So I was adamant we weren't winning this one. So any form of win I'm happy with, because whether it was a good performance or no, or if it's a third division team or no, these are games that have stumped us in the past.
It's refreshing to see an Aki's team no play particularly well but still win. You don't usually get to say that. I know the opposition wasn't the best. Edinburgh City really were pish, but
to be fair,
we played poor and won. So
last 10-15 minutes, I seen an equaliser coming. I thought they were starting to come into it. We were starting to look really nervy. The first half is what I'm really taking away for the game. Like you say, you don't know if it's just tired legs, second half or anything like that. But the first half, we really did dominate, and it's a way I've not seen us play in a long time. So it's a promising signing, like Brandon said. We'll probably go into it in more detail, but there's a couple of individual performances that really do give me hope for the year.
Absolutely. I mean, I mentioned just before this as well, the people of the likes of Callum Smith and Lewis Smith were the two that stood out to me, really. Lewis Smith in that first half, if he could just get the final ball, he would have had an excellent game. He just couldn't get that final pass, or he wasn't brave enough to take that shot. And Callum Smith, who obviously got the goal, probably created the most chances in the team. But the player, Brandon, that I'm sure you'll pick out, is your midfield maestro, Hakeem Adolphin, who again was outstanding yesterday.
He's obviously, as you say, Cam Smith, Lewis Smith were good. There was another couple of players that were decent as well, but they're getting all the plaudits because you might not expect them to be that level of good. Yeah. You expect Hakeem Adolphin to be like that. I tweeted that he could have his both eyes closed, break a leg, and he'd still be the championship player if he's here next season. He would. He's unbelievable. A lot of credit actually needs to go to Brian Rice, if we're being honest with you. We signed him for Livingston as a right back. He wasn't getting games at Livingston. Rice has turned him into a centre defensive mid, and he's unbelievable. Honestly, I've no felt this way about an Aki's player since Tony Andrew, if I'm being honest with you. I've got Tony Andrew up in my fucking living room more. Do you know what I mean? Hakeem Adolphin is unbelievable. He'll go into much bigger things than Aki's. But like I said, it was amazing, but because you expect him to be amazing, he's not really, really getting the plaudits of Callum Smith and Lewis Smith, but they're well and truly deserved to get plaudits, but Adolphin's just, oh,
he left the pitch to cheers of, we want you to stay, please don't go, and all that as well, which was great to see. All that. I don't know if you remember that.
I remember
everything. Which was great to see. David, if you had to pick one out, who would you pick out as the one to watch?
I definitely fell into that trap where I thought Adolphin had a brilliant game, and he did his job. I thought there would have been others that stood out more, but I think the point that Brandon makes is spot on, that it's because you expect, and he's delivered so consistently, where it's no surprise where Hakeem Adolphin plays the way that he does. Me personally, there's a few. I mean, Lewis Smith really caught the eye first half. I think it's one of the main things is because you've not seen him in so long. You forgot how good he is on the ball, how confident he was taking men on. Like you said, maybe kind of learning to shoot when it's appropriate and playing the final pass will definitely help him develop a bit more.
I think the confidence will come. As you said, he's not played in a long time. I think that's got a lot to do with it. It'll definitely come. Like you said, he's been, he saw the glimpses of how well we know he can play. And I think as long as he keeps fit and he keeps performing, the confidence will come and it'll just continue to shine.
I think Big Sean Want comes into the same category as well, because it's been that long since we've actually seen him play. He's so dominant. He's very organised. He was winning everything. I thought Brian Easton was excellent.
Easton
well
strolled it. Strolled it.
You consider, I mean, he's obviously a lot fitter than all the others, but when you consider his age, you'd be surprised to see him get about. The big boy up front for Edinburgh City looked a fit boy, and Easton kept him quiet the whole game. Another one that surprised me last night, again, he dropped off big time in the second half, but Regan Mimnaugh caught my eye a wee bit. I thought the thing I was always critical with Regan Mimnaugh was his physicality. He just looked like a wee boy, and any kind of half decent professional without muscling, but he was getting in amongst it last night. I thought he did well.
On the point of Regan Mibno and Ronan Hughes as the midfield, I said before this was in the first half when we were dominant and had the ball, I thought they looked great. In the second half when we were forced to sit back and Edinburgh City dominated, I think they were kind of ran over a little bit, in my opinion. You didn't see much of them. And that's not necessarily to say they had a bad performance. It was maybe just they were quietened right down because they were forced to sit back and defend rather than be on the ball.
And that's when, if you're winning a game, that's when you need a manager to step up and use his tactical sort of awareness. And we've talked about it several times last year, why in-game management needs to be crucial. I know it's only Edinburgh City and they were poor. If it's a better team there, and you're getting overrun with the two midfielders there, they'll capitalise easily. And that's why we were so reliant on O'Dolphin to do an extra job, really, because he was doing the job for himself and Mimno and Hughes and picking up everything for them because they are quite lightweight. As you say, when they're on the ball, I've been very critical of Ronan Hughes, but see on the ball, Ronan Hughes and Mimno, they're brilliant. They're really good players when they're on the ball. It's the other part of the game that they really need to sort of improve on. That's when your manager needs to sort of step up. If you're getting overrun, maybe time to bring on players. To be fair, we might not have the squad capabilities to bring on players just now, but I'm sure, as Vice said in the sort of post-match interview, we'll see that change in the next couple of days with players hopefully coming in.
What was your impressions of Joe Hilton?
He's picking very inconsistent. Which is a bit kind of iffy. But as you said, he didn't have anything to do until the 90th minute when he pulled off a great save. So I think he looks the part, but without really seeing him tested, you know, I think it's unfair to comment on him at the moment. I wait until the Falkirk game if he gets tested more there, and I'll be able to give you a kind of better answer.
The scary thing for me yesterday was looking at that bench. Don't get me wrong, there's tons of potential. Thought Kyle Monroe looked half decent when he came on, but we can't be using injuries as an excuse. I mean, that's the whole part of a season of football. You will get injuries. Teams around us will get injuries. That's not an excuse, and we used that as an excuse big time last season.
Yep.
But we're crippled with injuries. That's why you have a squad. That last night to me was like Brandon saying, if we were against a half decent team and we were chasing that in any way, we'd have been beaten because there was no changes to make. No disrespect to any of the young boys on the bench, but like I say, the talk is we want to be challenging and you need a strong squad. So, like I say, the interview Brandon mentioned, he says he's looking to bring in, what is it, two or three this week?
Yeah.
But they need to be of a calibre that are actually going to improve that starting 11 because last night, I think there's positions... I think defensively, we look like we'll be one of the strongest in the league. I think between Want and Easton alone, we've got options going forward with the guys like Kieran McDonald providing. We need a goal scorer. We need something else in midfield. Mm-hmm. And I do think we need a right back as well from last night.
Just before we go, it's nice to see the fans back last night. That was the biggest thing. It was so nice to walk in, catch up with people you haven't seen in ages, hear all the singing, hear all the chanting. And it was a great atmosphere. I know there was only, 100 of us, maybe, just over 100. But it was great. It was great to see. It was great to be back. And as I'm sure it's been all over social media, I do think it made a bit of a difference with the players. I do, especially in that last kind of 10, 15 minutes. As Sean once said in our interview, you know, sometimes the fans can give you that extra 10%. And I do honestly think the fans contributed to that.
It was amazing. I don't know, life felt... I don't want to sound so like a soppy box bastard, but it's just for that... I'm a bit lost for words now because it was amazing. Like, life's been pretty shit the past 16, 18 months, if we're being honest. It has. It's, especially when football is such a big thing for you and it means so much. And although they might piss us off pretty much every single week, Aki's Day means so much to you. And just having that bit of normality back, being, as you said, being with people you've not seen over a year, even just shitey, witty banter, folk are shouting at the players, like when David McFarlane's fucking Kier McDonald's running, oh, friends, shit like that. Mate, just wee shite fucking stuff like that, it was amazing. That's all I can really say. I just keep saying amazing, but it was amazing. It felt so good, mate. It felt a bit normal, and hopefully that's us on the way back to normality, and hopefully I can just continue with the 1-0 wins.
I did hear a couple of McFarlane's got a stoner.
McDonald's got a stoner.
I mean, he was driving home with a chubby the full way, so.
It's interesting to see how we kind of push on with the Falkirk game, because like Brandon said, I think a half chance to a decent team last night, we would have been in trouble.
Yep.
And I think Falkirk will be a better team. So don't get me wrong, we'll be further along the process by a week at that point as well, so might have a couple of guys in, might have a couple of guys back, but it'll be interesting to see how we kind of push on against a better team.
Absolutely, let's hope for it. Thank you very much for watching. If you did enjoy, hit the like button down below, and of course our socials are in the description as well for you to follow if you enjoyed it. Thank you for all the support on the Sean Warne interview. There was quite a few fans who pulled us aside last night and said they enjoyed it, so that was great. Hopefully you see what. Yeah, they did. hopefully there'll be a lot more of that kind of stuff on the channel soon. Now we're working in collaboration with the club, so that'll be good. But thanks for watching. We'll see you again soon.